فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد. My brothers and sisters, today inshallah ta'ala's benefit is on the advice and the reminder that was given to us by the noble companion Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud said, عليكم بالعلم, upon you is knowledge. فإن أحدكم لا يدري متى يفتقر إلى ما عنده. One of you is not aware and does not know if there will come a time when he is in need. When there will come a time when their people are in need of him. Seek knowledge now, because you never know if there will come a time when the people need the knowledge you have. عليكم بالعلم, seek knowledge and gain knowledge. قبل أن يقبض, before knowledge is taken. وقبضه ذهاب أهله, and knowledge being taken is by the people of knowledge going. This advice is very strong, wallahi. Today, you have the opportunity to learn and the chance to gain knowledge. You never know in what situation or what time will the people need a fatwa or an answer from you. You may be in a situation where you need to give an answer to your own self. This statement, wallahi, when you hear it from this noble companion, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, الذي عمر بعد وفاة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, he is one who had lived after the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم a very long age. He lived for a very long while. He lived after وزيريه, the two khalifa after the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم وخليفتيه, أبي بكر وعمر, أبو بكر وعمر. And Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, he is the one who felt بمرارة فقد معلم الناس الخير. He lost the sweetness and he tasted the bitterness of losing the most knowledgeable one, the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he also felt the bitterness of losing Abu Bakr and Umar, the two most knowledgeable individuals after the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And so he realized how important it is that one gains knowledge now before they lose the people of knowledge, before the people start needing you. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, he reached a time when the people started to need him. Before, the people needed the Prophet and they needed Abu Bakr and then they needed Umar. But there came a time when the people needed him. And so he's talking about the experience in which he went through. Because he saw the Prophet die, he saw Abu Bakr die, and he saw Umar die. And so he wants to tell us, learn and gain knowledge before the scholars pass away and they die. And before the people start needing you, because Abdullah ibn Mas'ud said about himself, speaking about the virtues which Allah has bestowed upon him. He said, لَقَدْ قَرَأْتُ عَلَىٰ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ, I read the Qur'an on the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, بِضْعًا وَسَبْعِينَ surah, 70 and odd surahs. وَلَقَدْ عَلِمَ أَصْحَابُ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ أَنِّي أَعْلَمُهُمْ بِكِتَابِ اللَّهِ. And the companions of the Prophet, they were aware and they knew that I was the most knowledgeable one in the Book of Allah. وَلَوْ أَعْلَمُ أَنَّ أَحَدًا أَعْلَمُ مِنِّي لَرَحَلْتُ إِلَيْهِ. And if I was to know anyone who had more knowledge than me in the Book of Allah, I would travel to him, or I would travel to them. شقيق, he said, فَجَلَسْتُ فِي حِلَقِ أَصْحَابِ مُحَمَّدٍ. He said, I sat in the gatherings of the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. فما سمعت أحدا يرد ذلك عليه ولا يعيبه. I never saw any other companion say that Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, he's not the most knowledgeable one amongst us. Or any one of them saying, he thinks he knows more than us. No one faulted him for that statement of his. And no one ever refuted him on that statement. Meaning, there came a time when Ibn Mas'ud was needed. Brothers and sisters, if you came to realize the powerful and the power that this statement of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud carries, عليكم بالعلم فإن أحدكم لا يدري متى يفتقر إلى ما عنده عليكم بالعلم قبل أن يقبض وقبضه ذهاب أهله. If that advice, it hit a big place in your heart, then strive hard. Especially my brothers and sisters, those of you who are young, who are small in age, it is important that you take this advice on board. Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he tells us, as Imam al-Darimi narrated in his Sunan and Al-Hakim narrated in his Sahih, that Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhu, when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, sorry, died, لما توفي رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قلت لرجل من الأنصار. Ibn Abbas said, I said to a man from the people of Ansar, I said to him, يا فلان, so and so, هلما لنسأل أصحاب محمد, come on, let's ask the companions of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, فإنهم اليوم كثير, because they are large in number today. Come on, let's go around the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Let's ask. فَقَالَ, he said, وَعَجَبًا لَكَ يَا ابْنَ عَبَّاسِ, amazement, you're fascinating, Ibn Abbas. أَتُرَى النَّاسَ يَحْتَاجُونَ إِلَيْكَ, do you think the people will need you? أَتُرَى النَّاسَ يَحْتَاجُونَ إِلَيْكَ, do you think that there will come a time when the people need you? Is that what you think? And a lot of brothers and sisters today, that's what they think to themselves. They don't think they will be needed. They don't even think that they will need their own knowledge later and benefit from it. You're in the middle of a desert. You don't have no water. How are you going to do tayammum? You want to start your own business. And you want to know what's permissible or not. How are you going to make your business and how are you going to do it? A lot of the people think that there are scholars who are alive, I won't be needed. And that's a person who has very low aspiration. This Ansari, he said this to Ibn Abbas, but this did not destroy Ibn Abbas's aspiration. So he said to him, وَعَجَبًا لَكَ يَا ابْنَ عَبَّاسٍ أَتُرَى النَّاسِ يَحْتَاجُونَ إِلَيْكَ وَفِي النَّاسِ مِنْ أَصْحَابِ مُحَمَّدٍ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ مَنْ تَرَى. And within the people are the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and you can see them amongst you. Why would the people need you? فَتَرَكْتُ ذَلِكَ Ibn Abbas said, I left that man. وَأَقْبَلْتُ عَلَى الْمَسْأَلَةِ, and he said, I faced seeking knowledge and asking questions. فَإِنْ كَانَ لَيَبْلُغَنِي, he said, it will reach me. فَإِنْ كَانَ لَيَبْلُغُنِي, he said, it will sometimes reach me. الْحَدِيثُ عَنِ الرَّجُلِ, that a man from the companions has a narration. فَآتِيهِ وَهُوَ قَائِلٌ, I will go to him. I will hear a sahabi has a hadith, and I said, I will travel and I will go to him. فَأَتَسَوَّدُ رِدَاءِ عَلَى بَابِهِ, and he will sleep, and I said, I will sleep in front of his door, and I will place my garment in front of my mouth, cover my face. فَتَسْتَفِي الرِّيحَ عَلَى وَجْهِ التُّرَابَ, and the wind and the sand, he said, it will go over my face. فيخرج فيراني, and he would come and see me. فيقول, he would say to me, يا ابن عم رسول الله, the Prophet's cousin, ما جاء بك, what brought you, ألا أرسلت إلي فآتيك, why didn't you send somebody to me so I can come to you. فأقول, I will reply by saying, لا, no, أنا أحق أن آتيك, I am the one who should come to you. فأسأله عن الحديث, and then I would ask him about a narration. قال فيبقي الرجل حتى رآني وقد اجتمع الناس علي فقال كان هذا الفتى أعقل مني. Until Ibn Abbas said, I remained to the extent that the people started to come around me to seek knowledge from me. And the Ansari man that I spoke to a while before, he saw me and the people were around me, and he said, كَانَ هَذَا الْفَتَى أَعْقَلَ مِنِّي. This boy, this young boy, was more smarter than I am. Ibn Abbas was young at that time, and he best benefited from knowledge at that young age. My brothers and sisters, الْعِلْمُ فِي الصِّغَرِ كَالنَّقْشِ عَلَى الْحَجَرِ. Knowledge at a young age is like carving into a rock. وَالْعِلْمُ فِي الْكِبَرِ. But when you want to seek knowledge at an old age, it is like كَالْكِتَابَةَ عَلَى الْمَاءِ. It's like writing on water. So now is the opportunity that you have in your life where you can benefit from. Do not let other people's statements put you off. Because everyone around you who has gained knowledge, they've all come out from the stomach of their mothers not knowing anything. As Allah said, وَاللَّهُ أَخْرَجَكُمْ مِنْ بُطُونِ أُمَّهَاتِكُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ شَيْئًا. Allah brought you out of the stomach and the womb of your mothers not knowing anything. No one came out with a head start. Everyone who you see who has become a scholar and a person of knowledge, they only surpassed you once they came into this world and they put so much effort in. I finally conclude by saying, my brothers and sisters, عليكم بالعلم, seek knowledge and gain knowledge. فَإِنَّ أَحَدَكُمْ لَا يَدْرِي, because one of you does not know, مَتَى يُفْتَقَرُ إِلَى مَا عِنْدَهُ, when will he be needed and will the people require that knowledge from you? عليكم بالعلم, seek knowledge and gain knowledge. قَبْلَ أَن يُقْبَضَ, before knowledge is taken. وَقَبْضُهُ ذِهَابُ أَهْلِهِ, and knowledge will go when the people who are carrying it go. I conclude for today's benefit with that. سبحانك اللهم بحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أستغفرك وأتوب إليك.